Hey guys, my name is Ryan Oakley, and I am a freelance illustrator. A lot of my work is inspired by film, fashion, and comics. And today I have a tutorial on how to draw faces.
Why won't you talk to me?
So in this tutorial, I will mostly be using Adobe Fresco. I start off my sketch using a pencil brush, and it starts off really rough, but then each layer I lower the opacity, start a new layer, and then clean up the lines until I get my final sketch. So for my images, I like to do a grayscale rendering, but I realized that my brushes weren't compatible in Adobe Fresco, so I just moved it over into Photoshop really quickly and move it back once I'm done.
Give yourself room to breathe. Not trying to offend you.
So for a lot of my drawings, I like to use mask, and how I do that is I use the selection tool. I select out my whole entire character, I'll drop in a color, and then I'll change the blending mode. And so for the skin, I change it to multiply so that all my grayscale rendering could show through. Similar to adding blush and color to the lips, I play with the opacity and the blending mode. So even for the clothing, I'm going to be using the selection tool and blending modes. It just speeds up my process, and then all I have to do is really worry about the rendering. Alright guys, our mysterious cowgirl is starting to look really good, but I thought, let me just take it back into Photoshop and play around with some of my tricks that I normally use in Photoshop. And so I'm going to give her this cool little halo. How do you get to these effects? Is you double click the little thumbnail image on your layer and it pops up, and you can play around with outer glow and inner glow, and then you change the blending mode to, I believe, a hard light, and then just play around with the colors. And lastly, I like to add this cool 3D effect to my images, and then I'll add a little bit of noise just to give the image an aged look. All right, our image is done, you guys, at this point, and so here's a quick little time lapse of everything done in Adobe Fresco.
Why don't you take it out on me? Take it out on me.
And lastly, for those of you that do not own an iPad, you can still use Adobe Fresco. So in my case, I ended up using my HP Spectre in addition to my 16-inch Cintiq. I also want to say thank you to Adobe and thank you to the Adobe Fresco team. If you enjoyed this video, give me a follow at Ryan Oakley Art on Instagram.